I want to start the program off today talking about one of my all-time favorite Youngevity products, the multifunctional glucogel caps, source of glucosamine, the well-known joint nutrient supplemented. We sell the, we market the glucogel caps for joints and for arthritis, but the glucogel caps do a lot more than help rebuild joints. They actually help rebuild the body in general. They specifically help rebuild the part of the body that we call the connective tissue. Glucogel caps are anti-aging in this way. They signal growth and repair. When we use our glucogel capsules, our blood levels of glucosamine go up, and this communicates to the body that there has been some kind of wounding. After all, why would there be pieces of cartilage components that are floating around in the blood unless a piece of cartilage has been torn off? The body doesn't know that we've been supplementing with our glucogel caps. It just sees cartilage components increasing, the level of cartilage components increasing the blood. It interprets this as a need for building, a need for repair, and a need for healing. And this is so relevant for health and wellness because the connective tissue growth that is stimulated by glucosamine affects 25% of the body. 25% or so of our body is made up of this stuff, connective tissue. Connective tissue is the white stuff on a piece of steak. It's responsible for keeping the body and its organs connected to each other and all in one homogeneous piece. The most well-known of the connective tissues is cartilage, which has a cushioning and shock-absorbing property. If your cartilage starts to wear off, your joints will rub against each other, and that can cause tremendous pain and distress. You'll find cartilage between the bones and the joints, the elbows, the ribs, the vertebrae in the spine, even in the lungs, the nose, the ears. If you squeeze your earlobe, you'll get a good sense of what cartilage can feel like. Cartilage is made up of special cells called cartilage cells, or technically chondrocytes, chondro being the Latin term for cartilage, site meaning being the Latin term for cell. These chondrocytes, or these cartilage cells, produce large amounts of fibers, collagen fibers, protein sugar complexes, substances like hyaluronic acid and glucosamine and chondroitin and elastin fibers. The thing about the cartilage is there's no blood vessels really to supply the chondrocytes with nutrients. Nutrients have to kind of diffuse through to the cartilage, and this lack of blood vessels makes cartilage repair itself much slower than other tissues. And this is why there's a myth out there that you can't repair cartilage. Not true, however. You can repair cartilage. Cartilage repairs itself all the time. It's just a little bit harder to do. One of the best ways to help repair and build cartilage is to take advantage of physical work and resistance training as an exercise or perhaps in weightlifting. In fact, exercise is a major stimulant for the growth of cartilage. If you're suffering from bone-to-bone arthritis or any other kind of cartilage defect or cartilage deficiency, exercise can be your best friend. In the body, there's a use-it-or-lose-it phenomena, and this is why it's been said that sitting is the new smoking. More and more, we're understanding the relationship between our sedentary lifestyles and the deterioration and the breakdown of the body. This is especially true about the connective tissue. Reducing toxicity is also important, especially sugar toxicity. Sugar can react with connective tissue and damage it and cause it to break down at a more accelerated or enhanced rate. And of course, nutritional supplementation is incredibly important, particularly protein. Whey protein, like you find in our Slender FX, the Ultimate EFAs, can also help turn on the production of connective tissue and cartilage. Vitamin C, which is found in your Beyond Tangy Tangerine in abundant amounts. Always want to do your vitamin C or your Beyond Tangy Tangerine when you're helping build or you're trying to help build connective tissue. And when you're taking your glucogel caps, which are stupendously valuable for helping build connective tissue and cartilage. Because aging is largely a function of connective tissue breakdown or deterioration, that means your glucogel caps have anti-aging properties. Hernias and prolapses, such as prolapsed uteruses or prolapsed rectums, various parts of the body can start to hang. This is a manifestation of a connective tissue breakdown. Hernias are a manifestation of connective tissue breakdown. And that means that your glucogel caps can help prevent hernias and prolapses and can help prevent gum disease as well. Your gums are largely made up of connective tissue. Leaky gut syndrome, where the digestive tract breaks down and toxins get into the blood. This can be a horrible problem associated with all kinds of degenerative diseases. Well, it turns out that the gut is largely made up of connective tissue and glucosamine, and the glucogel caps can help prevent leaky gut syndrome and all the subsequent health challenges that are associated. One of the most important aspects of the glucogel caps is the role it plays in skin health. Wrinkles are caused by connective tissue breakdown. You're not going to really, for the most part, with some exceptions, you're not going to really be able to address your wrinkles with a topical wrinkle cream. that you get in a department store, with the exception of vitamin A and vitamin C, which may have a connective tissue stimulating effect. For the most part, building connective tissue to prevent wrinkles and some of the effects of aging, crow's feet and fine lines, some of the effects of aging on the skin, is largely nutritional, and that's where your glucogel caps come in. Glucogel caps have multifunctional roles to play: skin, digestive tract, bone, cartilage, even in the heart, which has connective tissue, and the brain, which has connective tissue. You know, Alzheimer's disease and Parkinson's disease are in many ways a breakdown in the connective tissue in the brain. And once again, you'll find benefits by using your glucogel caps, along with your Beyond Tangy Tangerine and Ultimate EFAs, and all the other Mighty 90 essential nutrients that are found in the Youngevity products. I'm Pharmacist Ben. Got more great health information coming at you here right after our break. Our number is 831-685-1080 and 888-379-2552. We do have lines open for you if you have questions about the Youngevity products, health, or if you have a success story, or if you just want to contribute to the conversation. We want to hear from you. We'll take a quick break and come back with more good health information right after this. Don't go away. I'll be sitting in for the next 40 minutes or so, as I always do on the Dead Doctors Don't Lie program, with my good friend and colleague, Doug Winfrey. Greetings, Douglas.
Oh, great to have you back on the show.
Thank you.
I've got one here today that it's headlined, compound in broccoli may slow signs of aging. They say the fine lines creeping across your face and the inevitable aches and pains that come with advancing years. If you are like most, you want to delay the depressing signs of aging. New research suggests there's a simple answer: eat your greens. They say evidence suggests that it's more than just an old wives' tale, that by eating broccoli, cabbage, and avocado, you can ward off the signs of aging. Say a key compound known as NMN, or nicotinamide mononucleotide, is lurking in the green fruit and veggies, helps slow the physical signs of aging and can help rejuvenate metabolism. A test on mice showed that it reduces typical signs of aging, including skeletal muscle issues, poor liver function, lower bone density, and declining eye function, as well as worsening insulin sensitivity, immune function, body weight, and physical activity levels. There you go.
Well, guess what?
But
you can get some of that stuff in one of my favorite. I got a lot of favorite longevity supplements, but this is a new one that we haven't talked about a lot anyway. You may have talked about it with Doc. But you can get you can make your own NMN if you don't like broccoli. I don't know. I love broccoli. I don't want to knock broccoli, but some people don't like it.
Yeah, I have one theory on why
people don't like it.
No, there seems to be kind of almost an epidemic of people with low thyroid function. And, you know, every time in recent years that I've gone out to eat at a restaurant and I get, you know, steamed veggies as a side dish, it typically includes broccoli. And you got to figure, if people are eating tons and tons of broccoli, that there is that compound in broccoli that depresses thyroid function.
But I thought people didn't like broccoli. What's up with that?
I don't know.
Serving it all over the place.
Oh, I know. Well, the reason that is that it holds up really well. You know,
Is that why?
Yeah. You could leave it laying around in the refrigerator for quite a while before it goes bad, as compared to other types of vegetables.
Okay, I didn't know that, but I'll tell you what. It's a myth that people don't like broccoli. In fact, if you make broccoli right, it's almost irresistibly delicious. The problem with broccoli is because it's so medicinal, and all these vegetables, the cruciferous vegetables that you're mentioning, they're very medicinal vegetables. Broccoli, kale, cabbage, cauliflower, they're very medicinal, and they have bitter compounds. Anything bitter is medicinal. Sweet is calming, at least a little bit of sweet is calming, but bitter is medicinal and therapeutic. So what happens is when we munch down on our broccoli or our cabbages or our cabbage, when it's raw, we get these bitter compounds. But when you steam your broccoli, or you heat your broccoli, or your Brussels sprouts, or your cabbage, or your cauliflower, the bitter compounds are overridden. The bitter flavor is overridden by sweet compounds. You actually release sugars when you heat. That's why onions are sweeter. Cooked onions are sweeter than raw onions. You release sugars with heat. So when you put a little heat to your broccoli with steam, not a lot of heat, just a tiny, tiny little bit of heat with some steam, or maybe braising, you release the sugars, and the broccoli goes from a bitter compound to a sweet compound. And then if you put salt and fat, like butter, on top of your broccoli, that is delicious. Everybody loves that. It's just a combination of sugar and fat and sweet. And, of course, then you'll get the medicinal compounds, still get the medicinal compounds. And what you won't get, and this is really important, is you won't get those goitrogens, those thyroid suppressing compounds. Steam and heat tends to break those things up as well as releasing the sugars. There's a really cool nutritional supplement I want to tell you about that can mimic some of the effects, or it can help support some of the effects of this NMN substance, and we'll talk about that when we come back from our break. It's a great new longevity supplement. We'll talk about that here in just about a minute or so. You're listening to the Dead Doctors Don't Lie radio program. I'm Pharmacist Ben, along with Doug Winfrey, sitting in for Dr. Wallach. We'll take a break. Before much break, we're talking about some of the compounds in cruciferous vegetables, broccoli, cauliflower, cabbage, Brussels sprouts. Those are your main cruciferous vegetables. Very medicinal, super health-inducing vegetables. Probably the most protein-rich and medicinal of all the vegetables, arguably anyway. They do have some problems associated with them. They tend to be bitter, and those bitter compounds are the medicinal compounds, as Doug was pointing out. They also are goitrogenic, which means thyroid suppressing. Steaming them and heating these vegetables can release sugars and overwhelm those bitter compounds and reduce some of the goitrogenic thyroid suppressing compounds. So that's one strategy that you can use. If you absolutely don't want to eat broccoli, but you want to take advantage of some of these anti-aging compounds, like the NMN that Doug was referring to in our last segment, you can use a supplement called niacin. Yes, niacin. That nicotinamide, the N part of the NMN, a phrase or term, is actually a derivative of niacin, which you'll get in our Ultimate Niacin, one of my new favorite longevity products. I have a lot of favorite longevity products, but one of my new favorites is the Ultimate Niacin, which is a timed-release form of niacin. Pharmacists know all about niacin because it is considered to be the most powerful medicinal of all the vitamins, arguably along with vitamin C, but certainly a very strong case could be made for the fact that niacin is the most medicinal of all the vitamins. Niacin is so important for the body that it's the one vitamin that the body will make. It will make niacin from certain kinds of proteins, especially organ meats and dairy proteins. It can manufacture its own niacin. That's how important niacin is for the body. In the pharmacy, we used to always keep timed-release niacin because of its medicinal properties. Niacin deficiency is associated with brain defects and dementia. Things like Alzheimer's disease can be associated with niacin deficiency. Niacin is important for the body, how the body handles sugar. Niacin deficiency can cause GI problems, digestive problems. Niacin deficiency can cause rashes and dermatitises. Acne is associated with niacin deficiency. Even death itself can ensue under conditions of severe niacin deficiency. What I wonder is how many of us are suffering from what are called subclinical niacin deficiencies. That is, deficiencies in niacin that aren't severe enough to land you in the hospital, that aren't severe enough for you to even notice any dramatic symptoms. You may just be a little forgetful, or you may just have a little bit of skin rash or dermatitis, or you may just have a little bit of a digestive problem. Niacin's also involved in sugar metabolism, so maybe certain forms of diabetes or messed up blood sugar are also associated with niacin deficiency. And niacin is one of the all-time great nutritional supplements for helping lower blood cholesterol and lower blood fats. We used to keep it in timed release form in the pharmacy. And that's why I'm so excited about Dr. Wallach's latest formulation called the Ultimate Niacin, which is a timed release form of niacin. As many of you know, if you've tried to take niacin, if you heard about how important it is for brain health or for the digestive system or for lowering cholesterol, you may have tried to take niacin and you got something called the niacin flush. And the niacin flush is an effect that will keep people from getting the effective dose of niacin. Nobody wants the niacin flush. That's why timed-release niacin can be so, so effective. It's a way of getting a big old dose of niacin for dealing with blood fats, cholesterol, or blood sugar issues, or memory issues, or just getting a bunch of niacin into the system for whatever reason you want niacin without having to deal with a niacin flush. Take one of your Ultimate Niacins a day if you're dealing with any kind of heart problems, skin problems, mental health issues, high blood pressure, or if you want to simply lower your cholesterol levels or lower your blood fats. Niacin is nature's statin drug. Of course, it's not only non-toxic, instead of side effects, you get all the beneficial effects. All right, I'm Pharmacist Ben. Time to hit the phones. Who's first on the line, Douglas?
Let's head to California. And Sergio, you're on with Pharmacist Ben Fuchs.
Hey, Sergio.
Hi there.
What's going on?
I'm calling about a condition that my wife is suffering from.
Okay.
And she said it's called polymyositis.
Polymyositis.
And dermamyositis.
Okay. Now, go ahead.
Go ahead.
Well, I'll tell you what. she's not really suffering from polymyositis. Polymyositis is a inflammatory symptom. It's a, for the listeners, it's a, involves muscle weakness, basically. She also has skin problems, you said, dermatomyositis?
Yes.
Okay. So here's the deal. She's got to have something underlying that condition. She didn't just wake up one day and have polymyositis. It's a polymyositis is a long-term issue. It's a sign of long-term bodily breakdown. How old is your wife?
She's 54.
Okay.
She's so 57.
Oh, okay. Well, she's had many decades to break down, 4 or 5 decades for the body to break down, and this is typically what happens. Interestingly, polymyositis is a female problem more than it is a male problem, and a lot of diseases are like this. Whenever you have a female issue, a disease that affects more women than men, first thing you want to suspect is the hormone estrogen. Now, this is not a strange thought, because estrogen is very pro-inflammatory, especially in its toxic forms. There's not just one hormone called estrogen. There's many estrogens, some of which are toxic and some of which are associated with chronic inflammatory diseases, of which polymyositis and dermatomyositis are. They're chronic inflammatory diseases, and they're linked to estrogen. The best way to handle estrogenic issues is to work on the digestive system. This should come as no surprise to anybody who's hearing me speak, because I've been saying you got to work on the digestive system when you have a chronic long-term illness for decades. But the mechanism specifically involves how the body clears out estrogen, clears out toxic estrogen. You see, toxic estrogen is cleared out through bile, the liver. Also, probiotics in the gut are responsible for helping clear out, or partially responsible for helping the body clear out estrogen. Usually there's a component, a fat metabolism component as well. So the first thing you want to do is look for problem foods and eliminate those problem foods. Foods that are associated with diarrhea, constipation, heartburn, bloating, cramping. I'm guaranteeing you they're there. You probably know this. Sounds like you're somewhat self-aware, or you're aware of your wife's issues anyway. So you probably know that she probably knows she's got some kind of digestive health issue that's underlying these health problems. And it's usually something that's been going on for a while. Get her on the Ultimate Nightly Essence. Make sure she's using her Ultimate Enzymes with all of her meals. This is in addition to eliminating problem foods. You want to make sure she's using her Ultimate Enzymes, particularly with fatty foods. As I say, there's usually a component of fat malabsorption or dysfunctions in processing fats associated with these kinds of health challenges. Essential fatty acids can naturally balance out inflammation and naturally balance out excess estrogen, so make sure she's using her Ultimate EFAs in addition to the entire Healthy Start Pack. And also, it might not be a bad idea, whenever you have an inflammatory condition, to use your Fucoid Z. Fucoidin is wonderfully anti-inflammatory and can have really beneficial effects for all inflammatory health issues, particularly the myositis. So using the Fucoid Z 9 capsules a day may also be helpful. So long story short, work on the digestive system, focus on digestive support, eliminate problem foods, and make sure you're using the Mighty 90 essential nutrients. And then if you want to do one more thing, throw in a little bit of the Fucoid Z. And oh, by the way, Ultimate Selenium can also have an estrogen balancing effect. So she might want to toss in about 400 to 600 micrograms of the Ultimate Selenium. Thanks so much for your call. Appreciate it. Hope we helped you out. We'll take a break and come back with more good health information and your phone calls as well. Who is next in line, Douglas?
All right, let's head to Texas. And Moshtag, you're on with pharmacist Ben Fuchs.
Moshtag, is that right? Did I say that right?
Yeah, Moshtag. Hi, Ben.
Hi, how you doing? What do they call you, Mosh for short? They don't call you Moshtag.
Yes, Moshtag.
Moshtag, okay, Moshtag. What's going on? How can we help you?
Calling for a friend of mine. I actually called about him about 2 months ago, and he spoke to you.
Okay.
He has been diagnosed with colorectal cancer, and he started the nutrition, and then he also started radiation, and he did that for about the past month or so, maybe even 2 months. And he now is telling me that he has a lot of pain and diarrhea.
Oh, my goodness.
And just absolutely no energy from that. And so for the past 2 weeks, he did stop the radiation, but he still has the pain, diarrhea, and no energy. And
that's
he was
great.
Thinking about, B vitamins. You know, we tend to think about B vitamins when it comes to energy.
Yeah.
But he was thinking about injecting B vitamins.
That's not a bad idea. Yeah, that's not a bad idea. I love intravenous nutrition, and more you're going to see these these intravenous nutrition facilities popping up. We got a few of them in Colorado in the Boulder, Denver area that have popped up. And you're going to start to see this more and more, especially if you're dealing with a digestive problem, because one of the unfortunate effects of a digestive issue is you're going to have malabsorption. You're basically going to be starving to death, at least in terms of your micronutrients. So I'm a big believer in IV nutrition. And obviously, if you have colorectal cancer, that can impair the absorption of nutrients. So I'm a big believer in it, and it's a great idea. Think about intravenous glutathione, intravenous selenium, intravenous vitamin C, intravenous B complex, intravenous magnesium. That having been said, there's still lots of things that you can do with a good oral nutritional supplement program as well. How far along is he in his cancer? Do you know?
I believe he was diagnosed about a year or so ago.
But do you know stage two or stage? Do you know what the stages are, or what stage?
It's
like two or three, or advanced stage.
Two.
Okay, so here's the deal: if you have an intestinal cancer, it's a little bit tough to start dealing with it nutritionally. But there are things you could do. The most important thing you could do is give the intestine as little work to do as possible, and that means use liquid nutrients. This is one of the neat advantages of the Beyond Tangy Tangerine: is it's liquid nutrition. And this is one of Dr. Wallach's brilliant insights, among many brilliant insights. This is one of just a great idea. It was the idea that you can get more benefit from nutrition if it's liquefied first. So the Beyond Tangy Tangerine powder, liquid nutrition in high concentrations, especially high concentrations of the B vitamins, high concentrations of vitamin C, and high concentrations of the electrolytes might help. Now, he may have an absorption issue still, even with the liquid. And so you want to start him off slowly in the Beyond Tangy Tangerine. Don't try not to do too much all at once so he doesn't get even worse diarrhea, but small amounts of it throughout the day. Also, chicken soup is incredibly important for intestinal health, also for cancer, and also for the immune system. Not only does cartilage have very important building properties, we spent the beginning part of the program talking about one of the components in cartilage, which you'll find in the glucogel caps, which I'll tell you about here in a second. But cartilage also is important for the immune system. You may remember a book that came out about 40 years ago or so called Why Sharks Don't Get Cancer. And this was a book that described all of the sharks are very cartilage-rich animals, and it described how the cartilage that they contain helps protect them from cancer. Now, as it turns out, sharks do get cancer, but they get cancer at a very reduced rate. And it's thought that it's the cartilage that supports their immune system and fights cancer. Well, we human beings get the same benefits that the sharks get, and it turns out that cartilage is very important for the immune system, chicken cartilage especially, collagen from chickens. This is true for if you're dealing with autoimmune diseases. This is true if you're dealing with colds or viral infections or bacterial infections. And it's also true if you're dealing with cancer. So using bone soup with the cartilage, homemade chicken soup, also you can use get the cartilage raw materials or ingredients that are in cartilage, the components of cartilage, in your glucogel caps. And I would be doing high amounts of the glucogel caps in addition to the Beyond Tangy Tangerine. Ultimate Selenium also has wonderful anti-cancer properties, lest we forget the Fucoid Z, as well as the Restart Your Life products, which contain beta-glucan, are also very important for dealing with cancer. But most importantly is give the intestine as little work to do as possible. Fasting can help. Calorie restriction can help. Liquefying foods and using liquid nutrition can help. And then if he has foods, problem foods, and many of us do, particularly gluten and flour and dairy and eggs sometimes, those are foods that you're going to want to avoid if you're dealing with colon cancer. And God bless you and your friend. That's just a terrible curse, and I hope everything works out for you. Thanks so much for your call. Appreciate it. Who's next in line, Douglas?
All right, let's head to New Zealand. And Derek, you're on with pharmacist Ben Fuchs.
Hey, what's up, Derek?
Hey, Ben. I've got a customer who's got a granddaughter, and she's had trouble from day one. And I'll just read you out a brief history I've got of her. I don't know if it was real projectile vomiting, but she's been vomiting from day one. She does like 20 bowel movements a day, and
oh my goodness,
terrible.
Is she breastfeeding?
Well, she's 2 3/4 years old now.
She's what? How old?
2 years and 8 months.
Okay. Was she breastfed?
She was breastfed, but then the mum had pneumonia at some point, and the breast milk dried up.
Okay, now hang on. Let me just ask you a couple questions, Derek, okay? You say from day one, I assume you mean as soon as the baby was born, there were digestive health issues, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. And the baby's breastfeeding. Mom has got to be sick, all right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, how did I know that? Well, if the baby has a problem as soon as she comes out of the womb, there was a problem growing the baby in the womb, and there was a problem with the breast milk. All right? So at this point, now the baby's not being breastfed. Now it becomes extra, extra important, probably for the rest of that baby's life, that she take, I think you said it's a baby girl, right? Baby girl?
Mm-hmm.
Baby boy.
Yeah.
Okay, that she takes care of her digestive system. Really, really, we all have to do that, but she has to be doing it with extra vigilance. She should be getting some baby probiotics immediately. Immediately. That can be a world of difference for her. Also, if she can do fermented foods, she may not like fermented foods, but it would really be very helpful if you can give her a little bit of sauerkraut every day or some kind of fermented vegetables every day. If she has foods that are associated, what you want to do is you want to look for foods that are associated with digestive problems and eliminate those foods. You may find that she's allergic to dairy, grains, or has a gluten problem or dairy. Chances are she's got all of these issues. So she may not have a lot of foods that she could eat at first, but it's important that she stays away from any of these foods. Liquefying her foods, pretty much like we were talking about with our last caller, liquefying her foods can help. Giving her a teaspoon of maybe some kind of aloe vera product or noni product. Youngevity's got a couple of aloe vera products and noni products that you can use. A tablespoon a day or a couple of teaspoons a day might be helpful for her. Chicken soup, cartilage containing liquids can also be helpful. And then with a digestive problem, she's also going to be susceptible to malabsorption. That's going to affect her growth. So making sure she's supplementing is really important, especially with liquid supplements like the Beyond Tangy Tangerine. You probably want to break open, stick a pin in your Ultimate EFA capsules, and maybe squeeze a little bit on some applesauce or some kind of food that she likes to eat to make sure she's getting enough essential fats. You want to consider that this baby is not only reacting to foods, but she's also malnourished. Because with a digestive problem, she's not going to be able to absorb her nutrients. So supplementing for her is going to be very important. Your two main strategies are correct digestive problems, eliminate problem foods, and make sure she's on an all-around nutritional supplement, especially your Ultimate Nightly Essence. And also, it wouldn't hurt her to get on the Z Radical, which has a coating and soothing effect for the digestive system as well. All right, I hope that helps, Derek. Good luck. That's terrible, terrible thing for a young baby to have, and I hope we helped you out. You are listening to the Dead Doctors Don't Lie radio program. We will return right after this break. Who's next online?
James is in Ohio. You're on with pharmacist Ben Fuchs.
What's up, James?
Hi. How are you?
I'm good. How you doing? How are you doing?
I'm okay. I'm dealing with a couple of situations here.
Okay.
I've been a diabetic, and I don't know if you're familiar with the A1C.
Yes, I am.
Okay, well, right now, I've lost around 35 pounds over the past year or so, and my A1C levels are at normal.
That's awesome. Good for you. How'd you do it?
Well, basically, I did it through a lot of prayer first,
okay.
And then, watching my diet, and now I'm at normal blood sugar level and everything, normal blood sugar level. Okay, and then in the month of May, I had a cataract removed, and immediately after the cataract was removed, my eyesight improved immediately. Okay, and
hey,
then,
can I get you to turn your radio down? There's an echo in there. I'm having a hard time hearing you. Turn your radio down. So what's the bottom line here, my friend?
Okay, the bottom line is that with the cataract removed, they said I'm dealing with my eyesight, okay? When I had the cataract removed, everything improved. And then what happened was inflammation kept coming in. And they
Got
said it.
It
was my autoimmune, something dealing with my autoimmune
okay.
system.
Okay, say no more. We don't want to overthink this, okay? Basically, your body's breaking down, James, period. That's about all. Now, it's great that you lost the weight and your A1C is coming down because that means you're heading in the right direction. But you're probably dealing with some of the residual effects of decades of, with all due respect, mucking up your system, if you know what I'm saying. I don't mean to be gross or mean-spirited or anything. I'm just telling you like it is here. For decades, you were doing the wrong thing. The body was breaking down. But you're heading in the right track, and that's a good thing. So here's a couple more things that you want to do. If nobody's told you about the digestive relationship to diabetes, it's very important that you recognize that diabetes follows digestive system breakdown, especially at the intestinal level. Yes, it's a blood sugar problem, but it is preceded by what is called dysbiosis, which is a fancy way of saying messed up gut bacteria. So you probably know this, that you've had a digestive problem your whole life. Certainly you've had it in recent years. You know what I'm saying there, James? I'm sure you recognize this. So what you have to, and I'm not psychic. I'm not telling you this because I'm, you know, a wizard or something. I'm telling you this because this is how the body works. So you got to work on the digestive system. That's probably your main source of inflammation, and that means eliminating problem foods, using your nightly essence on a daily basis. The Fucoid Z can be very, very helpful for digestive health issues, as well as the ultimate enzymes with all of your meals. And by the way, when you do your ultimate enzymes with your meals, it always helps to do a little bit of apple cider vinegar to help activate those enzymes. So in addition to eliminating problem food and using your digestive support, it probably wouldn't hurt you to do some more liquid nutrition. Again, as we said a couple times already today, if you have digestive problems, you may be dealing with malabsorption and malnutrition. And interestingly, liquid nutrients like your B-complex and vitamin C and chromium and selenium and vanadium and what are called electrolytes, all of these play a role in helping your body process sugar and also play a very important role in the health of the eyes. So using your Beyond Tangy Tangerine can be very important. You might want to throw in the Vision FX. That can be helpful, as well as the Ocutive. Those are more specifically for the eyes. And then last but not least, if you're not already doing your Sweeties, get on the Sweeties. If you're not already doing your Ultimate Selenium, get on your Ultimate Selenium, maybe 400 or so micrograms a day. And as we talked about earlier in the program, the Ultimate Niacin is very important for helping the body process sugar, so make sure you're using your Ultimate Niacin as well. And then a couple other miscellaneous things. Make sure you're eating lots of green leafy vegetables and lots of colored fruits and vegetables. The greens and the colors are very important for eye health, and if you're not eating enough, there's a very good possibility that your eyes might not be getting what they need. So many things you could do for good health. And you know what, you guys? Nobody has to suffer from long-term chronic degenerative disease. It's not the body's way. It's a violation of the law. And it usually means that we're missing key nutritional supplements or we're not key nutrients and we're not absorbing those key nutrients. And that's where longevity comes in. Thanks so much for listening. I'm Pharmacist Ben for Doug Winfrey and Doc Wallach, all the folks at the ZBS Radio Network. Have yourselves a beautiful, wonderful, spectacular day. We'll talk to you all later. Bye for now.